Title of this talk is Drug-Resistant Hyperlipidemia and Therapeutic Options. Hi, my name is Pradeep Natarajan. I'm the Director of Preventive Cardiology at Mass General Hospital at Boston, Massachusetts. The key takeaways are to understand the major strategies for LDL cholesterol lowering and which strategies have been shown to improve cardiovascular prognosis. Let's first talk about LDL, or lipoproteins in general. The blood lipids are cholesterol and triglycerides. They're insoluble in the blood. They get packaged into complex macromolecules called lipoproteins. The lipoproteins are defined largely by the proteins, the apoproteins, that sit alongside the lipoproteins, typically on the surface of the lipoproteins themselves. A key feature of atherogenic lipoproteins, or those that influence atherosclerosis, is that they have the apolipoprotein B protein, or ApoB. The vast majority of ApoB-containing lipoproteins are LDL particle, low-density lipoprotein particles that house cholesterol and triglycerides. The way that we detect the number of LDL particles or the amount of LDL in the system is LDL cholesterol. That is the readout of the assay. It's the total amount of cholesterol in LDL particles. There are an increasing number of mechanisms by which one can pharmacologically lower LDL cholesterol. The tried and true mechanism pharmacologically is through step two. This is the inhibition of HMG-CoA reductase, a key rate-limiting enzyme step in the endogenous production of cholesterol. That's the target of statins. One step upstream is the enzyme ATP citrate lyase. That's the target of bempedoic acid, a newer medicine we'll talk about in a second. Separately, NPC1 is an important transporter at the intestinal surface. That is the target of ezetimibe. Ezetimibe has been in practice for over a decade. Step four is PCSK9. That's a new protein or a newly recognized protein that's involved in the endogenous destruction of LDL receptors. LDL receptors are important because they clear LDL from the circulation. PCSK9 normally prevents the recycling of LDL receptors to the liver surface to clear more cholesterol. And so inhibitors of PCSK9 prevent the degradation of LDL receptor and improve the clearance of LDL from the circulation. PCSK9 can be inhibited by inhibiting the protein itself. That's through monoclonal antibodies. That's step four. Or it can be also inhibited through the inhibition of its mRNA. And there is a new medicine called inclisiran, which is an siRNA aimed at inhibiting the mRNA. So drug resistance can be defined in twofold as it relates to LDL cholesterol. This is inadequate LDL cholesterol goal, and that's defined by insufficient LDL cholesterol lowering based on the first-line therapies, or it can be side effects limiting uptitration of a current medical regimen or the initiation of a planned strategy. Now, in the population, LDL cholesterol is strongly correlated with future risk for cardiovascular disease. On the right side, you'll see this as represented as non-HDL cholesterol. That's total cholesterol minus HDL cholesterol, the vast majority of which represents LDL cholesterol. There are also correlations with triglycerides, that's on the left panel, with increased cardiovascular disease risk, and HDL cholesterol with inverse correlations with cardiovascular disease risk. We won't talk about those two fractions today because the overwhelming evidence is in support for managing the non-HDL cholesterol as represented by LDL cholesterol. Now, there have been numerous randomized controlled trials of statins, that's step two, inhibitors of HMG-CoA reductase. Here you can see there is a monotonic relationship between the achieved LDL cholesterol and the cardiovascular disease risk of the group within the clinical trial. And that's obviously different across the different clinical trials, but all of them fit on this linear expectation. And that is in strong support of the causal relationship between LDL cholesterol and cardiovascular disease. Now, importantly, there are non-statin medicines that have shown that LDL cholesterol lowering through other mechanisms can also lower cardiovascular disease risk. This is step three. This is ezetimibe, the inhibitor of NPC1L1 that largely occurs at the intestine. In a clinical trial of baseline statin therapy, add-on ezetimibe among patients who had atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease lowered LDL and also lowered cardiovascular disease risk. The amount of LDL cholesterol lowering was modest, and so the cardiovascular disease benefit was modest, but largely fit that linear relationship between achieved LDL cholesterol and cardiovascular prognosis. Now, LDL cholesterol lowering with PCSK9 monoclonal antibodies have also been shown to be efficacious for improving cardiovascular prognosis. There have been two key clinical trials of two related agents, evolocumab and alirocumab. These are injectable medicines that are administered every 2 weeks. There is a formulation of evolocumab, which is administered once a month. This is at step 4. This is inhibiting the PCSK9 protein itself to improve the recycling of LDL receptors and improve the clearance of LDL particles from the blood circulation. These trials showed potent lowering of LDL cholesterol, and over a relatively short period of time, only about 2 to 3 years, improved cardiovascular disease prognosis. Like ezetimibe, these medicines are also in clinical practice. They are approved for LDL cholesterol lowering and improving cardiovascular disease risk. There are some newer medicines that have been more recently approved in the United States. One is bempedoic acid. This is the enzyme that is just upstream of HMG-CoA reductase. Bempedoic acid is a prodrug, meaning it's inactive when it's ingested. It's an oral medicine. And to help combat potential statin-associated side effects, this prodrug is only activated in the liver itself. And it is very specific for inhibiting ATP citrate lyase. These individuals have modest LDL cholesterol lowering, and there are ongoing clinical trials testing and confirming that this non-statin strategy to lower cardiovascular disease risk would also be clinically efficacious. You see on the right side is the LDL cholesterol lowering efficacy of inclisiran. This is an siRNA aimed at the PCSK9 mRNA. This is an injectable that is administered every 6 months. And here you see potent lowering of LDL cholesterol without substantial variability despite the long interval dosing. This has also been approved by the FDA as well.